Joining me now is Special Advisor to President Donald Trump, Tony Sayegh. Tony, thank you so much for being here with us here at the Daily Caller. You were recently tapped to join the non-official war room at the White House. So tell us about that and tell us why they didn't want to go the war room route, the official one.
Well, first of all, great to be with you, Stephanie, and thanks for having me here at your Daily Caller office. Look, the president did nothing wrong. We've known this all along. You know, the war room concept is a very nice and interesting one from kind of the impeachment of Bill Clinton in years past. You know, we have a different mentality. We just need to make sure we get the facts, you know, out to the American people on the process, on the substance of the case, and frankly, on the politics of the case, because on all three, we prove that the president obviously is completely vindicated when you look at all of this, when you understand the actual way this impeachment process has been run. It's a total sham. It's been designed from the very start of the Trump administration to undermine and delegitimize the president. So look, we know that we have to obviously participate. We know that we obviously have to stand up for the president and for the presidency, the institution of the president, very strongly, and we're ready to do it. So whatever it's called, war room, battle station, you know, we've come up with a lot of funny names for it. The truth is the president has a lot of allies, both inside the administration and the White House, on Capitol Hill, and throughout the country, all who have really been galvanized by this complete impeachment nonsense and are willing to obviously do our part to stand up for him in the country.
Okay, so you just described it as a battle station. What exactly is going on at the battle station? Obviously, every single day is a new and different day. You've been joined by the former Attorney General of Florida, Pam Bondi. So what's it like?
So whenever you have a singular issue that takes an outsized amount of time, and unfortunately the Democrats have chosen to throw this impeachment wrench into this entire time where we're doing so many other important and instrumental things for the country. Don't forget, we just had some of the best job numbers ever announced, best in 50 years. We have wage growth. People's paychecks are going up for the first time in 10 years. The lowest wage workers are actually getting the biggest net percent benefit of that wage growth. We just decimated ISIS, killed al-Baghdadi. You have the president standing up for our country on the world stage with NATO. We're getting them to pay their fair share into the strategic Northern Atlantic alliance. So while we're doing all these important things, the Democrats have kind of forced this impeachment issue inside the process. And what we're trying to do is make sure we're focused every day on combating all of the lies, all of the mistruths, all of the sham nonsense that has been pushed out by Adam Schiff, Nancy Pelosi, Jerry Nadler, and others who have been hyper-focused on pushing this baseless impeachment on the American people from day one. Don't forget, Stephanie, in July of this year, you had almost 80 votes in the Democratic caucus to impeach the president over a tweet they did not like. They are completely trivializing impeachment, which is the most monumental power Congress gets to keep the president in check and hold the president accountable. I mean, if you really think about it, back during the Obama administration, we had Fast and Furious, a gun-running, complete program that led to the death of a U.S. federal agent. You had the IRS targeting, where American citizens and people participating in our democracy were targeted for their conservative political beliefs by President Obama's IRS. You had the Department of Justice under Eric Holder targeting reporters because of disagreements. These are all things any Republican could have easily at any point said, we should try to impeach Barack Obama, but we didn't. We ran against them on these issues. We took our case to the American people. They reelected Barack Obama. That's how democracy works. The Democrats have every right to run on an issue where they might have disagreed with the president on his phone call with the Ukrainian president, holding aid because we were concerned about burden sharing and corruption in the Ukraine, which we know for a long time has been systemic. But no, they rush to build a case on impeachment, and they fail to build the case. These two articles don't represent crimes, high crimes and misdemeanors. They talked about bribery, they talked about extortion, they talked about quid pro quo. That's not what the articles say. They're talking about abuse of power, which, by the way, Congress is actually doing. It's a little bit of a projection. They're the ones abusing their constitutional power to impeach, yet they're suggesting President Trump abused power, of which there's no factual evidence whatsoever. It's their opinion. And then they come up with this obstruction of Congress charge, which, make no mistake, is made up. It is a completely fabricated charge. They know that obstruction of justice is an actual crime. They can't prove it because it didn't happen. So they came up with some wordplay, wordsmithing, and come up with this fake charge of obstruction of Congress, which is a dangerous precedent. Don't forget, we have a Constitution. The Constitution has identifies three co-equal branches of government. The executive can't tell the legislative what to do, and the legislative can't tell the executive what to do. If there's a fight there, as there is now, you go to the judicial branch, and they're the source of remedy for the fight between the executive and the legislative. Under Adam Schiff's definition of obstruction, going to the judicial branch is obstruction. I mean, think about what that says about our constitutional process and our constitutional system. So clearly, the Democrats are engaged in a lot of nonsense, but actually some of this is really dangerous for the preservation of the Constitution and our institutions of government.